all witnessed the interesting experiences during the Trump administration, you know, and I'm sure that was one experience that actually put whistleblowing in the limelight, and you could see how that was dramatized in the operations of the American government, where whistleblowers were blowing the whistle on activities of the executive branch, to the extent that it also impacted on the president himself, and where the president was trying to get at the identity of the whistleblower and the protections that were activated to give that identity, make that whistleblower's identity anonymous to the extent that it was possible, and the fallout when his identity also became revealed and all that transpired thereafter. That experience dramatized the lived experiences of whistleblowers and why they need protection, including that of anonymity. But you could see that the fact that the whistleblower was against the highest office in the land, you know, did not put that whistleblower out of the protection that he deserved. And despite the efforts of the highest office in the land to go after the whistleblower, at least he had the available protections within the policy and legal framework in the U.S. So basically saying that the need to have whistleblowers protected cannot be overemphasized, and that even in more established democracies, whistleblowers also suffer a lot of pressure, which is why if in developing economies like ours, we have to go the extra mile to actually ensure that they even have greater protection, given the fact that our systems of checks and balances are not as robust as it happens in some of these other countries.
Supported by MacArthur Foundation.